As the Sun and Moon anime is releasing, I wanted to talk about one of my favorite aspects while watching Ash go along his journey, catching new Pokemon. With the brand new Pokemon popping up in the 7th generation, as well as the Alola forms, the various personalities of each Pokemon being on Ash's team for however long he decides to not release them is something I know a lot of us look forward to. Today we'll be discussing 10 of the possible Pokemon that would make the anime series more enjoyable, and try to guess which Pokemon Ash will really catch. Welcome everyone to the top 10 Pokemon Ash might catch in Pokemon Sun and Moon. Hope you enjoy. Number 10, Toucanon. Ash has always captured the starting route bird Pokemon and evolved it fully, which is why I decided it'd be a good Pokemon to start this list off with at number 10, since it seems pretty guaranteed, so it wouldn't be that much of a prediction. That could change, however, seeing as he already has a bird Pokemon in Rowlet. Although he only captured 5 different Pokemon in Kalos, and 3 of those were flying, so getting a Toucanon seems very likely. I think it'd be hilarious for him to have this angry-looking bird Pokemon, especially if it was interacting with Rowlet after Rowlet's introduction into the anime. It'd be a great addition to Ash's team as a very serious and angry Pokemon that uses cool moves like Beak Blast. The personality of Toucanon could be a funny juxtaposition for Ash's team, as he could have a silly, cute Rowlet and his personable Pikachu would have the stern, probably mad at you Toucanon to keep everyone in line. Number 9, Alolan Vulpix. If there is one Alola form Pokemon that Ash might get for his team, it's possible that Vulpix would take that spot. I feel that the writers could choose to have Ash catch one of these as a sort of nod to his good old thirsty friend Brock. Alolan Geodude could be likely as well, but Ash has never captured any electric Pokemon aside from Pikachu, so I don't think he's going to be starting now. If he does catch a Vulpix here, however, I don't think it'd be on his team very often, and might be used as a counter for a certain battle. But who are we kidding? Ash doesn't strategize. Alolan Vulpix does look very majestic, and feels like a Pokemon Ash would try to catch. However, I don't think it'd be long before he switches it out for someone else. Or releases it. Just like Brock. Number 8, Incineroar. Now, I do know the Japanese episodes are already up to episode 7, and I know what happens, but I won't be mentioning any of the episodes that haven't been released in North America for anyone who hasn't seen it, so no need to worry. That being said, this still feels like a region where Ash would get all 3 of the starters. At least I hope, because it would be cool. It'd be really fun to get another fully evolved fire Pokemon on Ash's team as well, since last season we had Greninja, and this season, well, I want Rowlet to stay Rowlet, so Incineroar it is. It also just looks like another really tough-looking Pokemon that could make some really interesting episodes if it was on Ash's team. I definitely can see it disobeying Ash again. Also, it's a dark type, just like Greninja, so you can fill the void of not having Greninja with Incineroar. Goodbye, Ash Greninja. We knew you well. Number 7, Rockruff. Now, I think Rockruff is a little bit unlikely for Ash, but I would still love to see it on his team. This might be the kind of Pokemon Ash would try to fight over with one of his fellow journey-goers, but might not necessarily capture. At the same time, however, I could see him, and whoever he is with, both obtain a Rockruff of their own, and having each of them evolve into the different forms. If that happens, I could see Ash getting the day form, and his friend getting the night form. Number 6, Mudsdale. After Ash riding that Rapidash in the first season, he's gonna need some new wheels that are just as powerful and just as majestic. That's where Mudsdale comes in. Mudbray has a fitting personality for Ash. Its Pokedex entry describes it as stubborn and eating dirt, which I'm sure Ash has done at some point. But after a few episodes of relating to this donkey and evolving it into a horse with leg warmers, I'm sure Mudsdale could be the trusty steed that Ash deserves. And it has a bunch of ground moves, so Ash doesn't even have to try. Don't use them on the flying Pokemon, Ash, you know that. Number 5, Ribombee. I hope I'm saying these names right. It has been quite some time since Ash has had a new Bug-type Pokemon. The last time he had one was Heracross, and he has never had a Fairy-type Pokemon, so Ribombee seems like a great addition to his team. Cutiefly also looks like the type of Pokemon that would bump into Ash and just follow him around until he catches it. It has that needy look. I think it would be a very fun Pokemon to see Ash train, and Cutiefly has this weak look that you wouldn't really fear in battles. It could definitely set up an episode where Cutiefly is getting beaten badly in battle and finally evolving to take down whatever challenge Ash is dealing with. Possibly Team Skull, as Guzma uses Bug Pokemon as well, so he might make fun of its innocent look, forcing it to evolve into a more powerful Ribombee. Number 4, Brionne. Popplio's evolution. Now, I did say this feels like a region where Ash would get all of the starters, so I had to make sure one of Popplio's evolutions was on this list. I thought it'd be cool if Ash had Rowlet, Brionne, and then Incineroar, so he could have one stage of each starter Pokemon. Now, I do know that Lana already has a Popplio, so I'm gonna make the bold prediction of saying she gives it to Ash, and Ash will evolve it once. This Pokemon really reminds me of Bayleaf, and I think he'd love Ash just as much. I don't think Ash would evolve it fully, as he already had Greninja, and Primarina doesn't really suit Ash as well, but it's still a possibility. Number 3. Alolan Exeggutor. Look, I don't actually want this to be a thing, but I just have this feeling in my gut that Ash is gonna catch an Alolan Exeggutor. It'll be like his Muk or Snorlax, where he rarely uses it, but it'll be there, in his collection of not catching them all. And if this is the only dragon type he gets, so help me, I will write a strongly worded top 10. Don't you make me do it, Ash. I don't know how you'll catch an Alolan Exeggutor, but it's gonna happen. There'll be some weird scenario where he bumps into one and then he's forced to catch it. And you know, it might not happen, but I know you cheeky Pokemon writers, they want this to happen. They've had it planned since like Gen 3. Don't do it, Ash. Don't you do it. Number 2. Jangmo-Oh. Ash has been getting more and more dragons through each season of Pokemon. In Kalos, he caught two different dragon-type Pokemon and fully evolved them as well, which is why I think it's very possible for him to catch a Jangmo-Oh in Sun and Moon. It'll probably be somewhere not too far from the end of this season, where he'll catch it and then have it on his team, fully evolved until the end. I think it's really cool when Ash gets these powerful Pokemon on his team, so getting a brand new pseudo-legendary by fully evolving a Jangmo-Oh into a Komo-Oh would be another great experience to see Ash as he enters his 19th year of going on his Pokemon journey and still being 10. Number 1. Beware. Even though Ash had that pretty frightful encounter with a Beware, the look on his face before it savagely attacked him was a look of excitement. I'm sure he could get over his traumatizing experience and catch one in due time. It's the perfect combination of adorable but fierce. One moment it's in a battle looking timid, the next moment it's demolishing the Aether Paradise. Sounds exactly like Ash. I can just see Beware, carrying Ash through a Pokemon battle and being a stubborn enough Pokemon to suit Ash's personality while he does it. That first Beware was just foreshadowing. Imagine Ash's face turning blue as he receives a multitude of hugs from Beware. That would definitely be the running joke of this season if he catches one. Thanks everyone for tuning in, hope you enjoyed this top 10 of the anime. Please make sure to leave a like and subscribe, and I'll also try to update the Sun and Moon LP as soon as I can. I'm just a little sick. Again. Hope you enjoyed, and until next time, keep on catching!